Hello everyone, welcome back to the part 6 of the series. In this video, we'll see what are tuples in Python. We'll also see how to create a tuples, indexing and slicing of tuples, or accessing of tuple elements, operation on tuples, and also functions on tuples. Addition to this, we'll also see some of the built-in functions for tuples. So let's get started. So I am here on my Google Colab notebook now. So let's start with tuples. So what are tuples? Tuple is similar to list, but it is immutable. So what is immutable now? Immutable in the sense, once the tuple is made or constructed, it cannot be changed. Whereas lists, even after making it, we can change the list. For an example, we cannot add dot append, dot extend in tuples. In list, we can do the same. Let's create a tuple first. Remember, tuples are created using parentheses, whereas lists are created using square brackets. So let me create an empty tuple first and see what is the type of it. So I create tuple tuple and then make it an empty tuple. And also see what is the type of this. Type of tuple. So it's tuple. Now let's add one element inside a tuple. Tup equals to 1. And remember, whenever you are adding only a single element inside a tuple, you need to add a comma at the end. Else it will take it as an integer. For an example, if I don't add a comma now and then print the type of the tuple, type of tup, what it is, it will give me an integer. If I add a comma with this, this will change to tuple. So always remember, whenever you are declaring a single element inside a tuple, you need to add a comma after the first element. Now we'll see tuples with the different data types. So let's create again and add an elements 1, 2, 3, 4. Now also add an alphabet. Let us also add a float value and then print this tuple, print tup. Here. So it's printing all the elements available inside the tuple. We can also declare a tuple without a braces or parenthesis as tup equals to, it can be 1, 2, 3, 4, a, and even this is a tuple type of tuple. So we have two ways. We can even use parenthesis or without a parenthesis. It will result in the same, that is tuple. We can also create a tuple using list. How? Let me create a list first. So as we know, list is declared using the square brackets. So square brackets, let me add the elements 1, 2, 3, 4, and also a variable alphabet. Now the type of this is list. So if I just print this, so it is a list. Now let me convert the same thing to a tuple. So for that, I write a tuple name, that is tup, or anything it can be, equals to tup le tuple. I call up the list. Now if I print the type of list, type of tup, it is a tuple. This tuple holds a value, what is there inside the list. For an example, let us see what it holds, print tup now. So it should have all the elements what was there inside this list. So as you can see now, the elements inside this tuple is exactly the same, the elements what we had inside the list. So this is how you can create a list. So you can create a tuple using a list. Now we'll see accessing a tuple. Accessing this tuple is exactly the same way as we access the lists. Here also we'll do indexing and slicing. Let me create a new variable, new tuple a equals to, and add up the elements 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and also add up few characters. Now let me print or slice. As we know, the very first index in indexing, the very first element will be 0 followed by 1, 2, 3, 4. And if it is a negative index, the last element will be minus 1 followed by minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, so on in reverse order. So let me print the second value, that is 2. So it is index value is 1. So if I print a of 1, so it should return me value of 2 as a is index 2. Sorry, 2 is index 1. I can also print in a range as we did for the list, that is a range from 1, 2, 3, 4. So it should give me all the values starting from the range 1 till 4. So I get the values 2, 3, 4. So this is how I can access the tuples, that is indexing and slicing of the tuples. Now let us see some basic operations on tuples. If you want to find the length of the tuple, what I do is use function len, len length, and then call up the tuple name, that is a. So what is the length of our tuple a? That is 7. It has 7 elements inside the tuple, so I get 7. Unlike the lists, as we did in there, if you want to repeat the tuple 2 times or 3 times, all you need to do is call up the tuple, multiply it with the number of time you want to repeat it. For example, 2 here, if I do this, I get the same tuple 2 times. That is the same tuple 2 times. I can also concatenate the list tuples. So let us do this. I have one tuple, that is A. Let me create another tuple B. B equals to assign a values comes 2, 3, 4, or whatever you want. It's really not needed that what I do, you do it. A or B and so on. So now if I want to concatenate the two tuples, I print A plus B. So it should give me the values stored in both tuples A and B. As you can see here, until here is the first tuple and from 2 it is the second tuple. By this, I can concatenate the two tuples. Now consider I want to find out whether some value exists inside the tuple. Let us consider I want to check out whether 1 is there inside the tuple A. So what I do is print 1 in A. Print 1 in A. So if 1 is present inside the tuple A, it should give me true, as you can see here. Let us try with some other number. Print 6 in A. So as it is not present, it should return me a value of false. Here, it returns me a value of false. We can also do some other operations and functions on tuple. We saw one was length. We can also find a minimum value or a maximum value. So we'll see that. Let us create another tuple C equals to, like, assign value 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and then find the minimum of this tuple C. So the minimum value inside this tuple is 1. I can also find maximum using max and call up the tuple C. So the maximum value inside this tuple C is 6. Now for an example, you are not sure how many values are there. For example, 1. So how many times 1 is repeated inside a tuple? So how can you do that? For that, what you do is, let me create another tuple having multiple values. C equals to, again, 1, 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 4. Now, let me see how many times 1 is there inside the tuple C. So for that, what I do is, call up the tuple name c, comma c dot count, and the value which I want to count, that is 1. So it returns me value of 3 as there are 3 ones inside the tuple C. Consider I create one more tuple Q equals to and then assign a random values in any sorted order, any order 3, 2, 5, 8, 1, anything. So now this is completely unsorted. They are not in any manner. So if I want to sort them out, I can do that. For that, what I should do is sorted. And then call up the tuple Q. So this will return me all the elements inside the tuple in a sorted manner. As you can see here, 1, 2, 3, 5, 7, 9, they are in ascending order. As I said earlier, tuples are immutable. That is, they cannot be changed once created. So now I have created, as you know, I have created a tuple Q. Let me try to append something to this tuple. That is Q dot append. And then write value 3 and try to print Q again. So it should return me an error. So I cannot do this because tuples are immutable. They cannot be changed once created. Q dot remove 1. And then print Q. So as you saw here, even this gives me an error. Whereas in list, I was able to remove or an add an element inside the list. Whereas in tuples, I cannot do that thing. As you saw, I was not able to append or remove anything after making or creating a tuple. Whereas in list, I was able to append or remove or modify the elements inside the list. Hence, tuples are immutable and lists are mutable. Tuples are declared using parentheses. They can also be declared without using any parentheses, directly separated by commas, whereas lists are declared using square brackets. So with this, we end up this video for today. If you like the video, please click on a like button. Subscribe to the channel, and thanks for watching.